what we're here to do on this voyage is to, there are three or four main parts to the voyage, but basically we're looking at how the Southern Ocean is behaving today, what the temperature, salinity, oxygen, carbon dioxide levels, what organisms are living in the sea and where, and relating those distributions to the ocean currents, and also comparing what we measure today to measurements we've made in previous decades. Work we've done in the past has shown that one of those sinking motions around Antarctica, where water sinks down to great depth, down to 4 or 5 kilometers below the sea surface, that seems to be slowing down with time. The water that sinks is becoming fresher, that is less salty, and less dense. We know that in previous parts of the previous periods of the Earth's history, that changes in those sinking motions in the polar regions have been linked to changes in climate. We haven't seen changes in climate result yet from the changes in Southern Ocean currents, but it's moving in the direction that would drive the similar sorts of changes to those we've seen in the past. So the Southern Ocean is important for climate because it has these unique circulation features. And so if the Southern Ocean changed, it would be significant for us. And the evidence we have so far is that the Southern Ocean is changing. It's warming, and to greater depth and at a faster rate than the global ocean average. And it's also changing its salinity. The salinity changes are important for two reasons. One is that part of the salinity changes are being driven by more rainfall and snowfall than happened in the past. That's exactly the sort of signal that we expect to see as a result of global warming. That is, the areas that are dry, where there's more evaporation than precipitation, will get drier and saltier in the ocean. Places where there's more rainfall than evaporation will tend to get wetter or fresher in the ocean. And that's what we've been seeing over the last couple of decades, is that the salty areas of the surface ocean are getting saltier and the fresher areas are getting fresher. And we see that signal in the Southern Ocean. We also see those changes in salinity down deep, right along the seafloor. And that's giving us a hint about how the ocean's interacting with the ice sheet on Antarctica. As the ice spreads off the Antarctic continent into the sea, it starts to float and forms glacier tongues or ice shelves. Where that interacts with the ocean can either melt, if it's warm enough, it can melt the bottom of the ice, or it can actually freeze to the bottom of the ice. The evidence that we found for freshening around the edge of Antarctica is an indication that that melting process is happening more rapidly than it did in the past. And that's a result of the warming of the ocean, we believe. And part of what we're doing on this trip is trying to confirm that picture.